Bundibugyo and Kasese districts have been grappling with the aftermath of heavy rainfall, resulting in severe flooding that has left communities in distress. The floods have not only caused significant damage to homes but also compromised vital flood control infrastructures, exacerbating the challenges faced by the local residents. Mate Jakas, the Bundibugyo District Natural Resource Officer, says in extreme cases, people have lost lives.
Common disaster we experience is flooding, like on this river Kirumia. We also experienced landslides almost in all the entire 27 local governments of this district. We have severe soil erosion, and to some extent we have river bursting.
The Food and Agriculture Organization has started a campaign to repair the flood-damaged infrastructure in Bundibugyo and Kasese districts. We have been having challenges whenever it rains. Floods fill up this place. But with the intervention of FAO, we are saying goodbye to the challenges, but we still need more support since all areas are not yet worked on. The campaign from FAO also aims at strengthening flood early warning systems, preparedness and anticipatory action in hotspot areas in the two districts. The campaign also seeks to reduce the impact of the expected floods given the force in heavy rains related to El Nino. It also supports the communities at risk to cope with the flooding and to enable fast recovery.
In the long run, we need to do more than the decision. We need to find the cause where this soil seems to come from and train the communities around to practice better methods of agriculture, which includes soil conservation on farm.
Help us, the water not to go in the town. But we still need support to them, because this is not enough for the people.
According to Fred Byamukama, the State Minister for Works and Transport in charge of transport, out of the 580 billion shillings needed, 210 billion shillings will be used to repair roads and bridges in the Elgon region, while the balance will be used in other parts of the country.
Local government should emphasize sensitization to the local community. They should create a buffer zone towards these local, natural features to maintain the purity of the water.
Government, through the Minister of Works this week, revealed that it needs 580 billion shillings to repair roads and bridges destroyed by the El Nino in the whole country. Story by Jonathan Tusingure for the news.